Hello, so my name is Nikos Nikolotsakos. I'm from GRNET. This is the Greek research and network provider in Greece. We are a partner to the EUDAT collaboration. So today I'm going to present you the EUDAT CDI infrastructure that it's been used for all these download data requests. So it's from the side of it's more technical and which technologies and which services are actually used in order to provide you with the HTTP APIs service. Okay, so EUDAT CDI is a network of nodes that provide the facility to upload, retrieve, identify and replicate data. And actually it's not just a few nodes, it's a combination of nodes, of a lot of nodes in each data center that is involved. Okay, so the core service that provides the HTTP URL, it's called B2Stage, and it's developed by EUDAT. It's one of the core services. It offers the functionality for easy data transfer between EUDAT resources and external facilities. So make it easier to move your data from your data center to an external. It is built with the IROTS software stack. This is an open source project that it's developed to host data in a distributed way. And it also the B2Stage also implement a RESTful HTTP interface. RESTful means that you can access your data through a web URL and upload or download there. So here is an overview of how this B2 services is used. So basically, the B2Stage here works as a proxy. The B2Stage core service works as a proxy when you send a request for uploading data. Then your data is registered with the B2 handle. This is the and gets a PID, a persistent identifier. And also it's stored to the data servers with the service that is called the B2Save. So here are the five partners of the EUDAT team. So this is GRNET, CSC, DKRZ, STFC and Sineca. All those members are committing their data center and their resources to host the distributed data and to replicate all the information between the data centers. Here is the software stack that is used to implement the core service. So we have the HTTP APIs that we are using the B2Stage service. Then we have the IROADS. This is an open source project that is used for data storage and for replicating the data among the data centers. Then we have the PID, persistent identifiers. This service is called the B2Handle, And we use this to register the data and for data identification. Then we have a salary. This is used for asynchronous operations. So for example, when a lot of requests are coming through the bitstage proxy, we have to serve them in parallel. So this is where the salary service is used. Then we have Rancher and Docker. So all this configuration and all these servers are deployed through Docker, and Rancher is a deployment stack for Docker. And last we have a RabbitMQ. This is a messaging software that which it gathers all the logging in a centralized way. So for each request, we have to keep a log that when and where its data resides. So again, here is how this all the software is actually implemented on the production service. So there is also a Docker registry infrastructure. This is where all the Docker files are hosted in order to be used later from the EUDAT services. We have a Rancher that is orchestrating all the services and handles the quality checks. We have three setups of this environment. We have a development environment, a test environment, and a production environment. The development hosts all the latest version of each software and is used only to develop and create new capabilities. It is only accessible to other developers of EUDAT, MARIS, and iFramer. It doesn't host the actual data, it's only temporary data for development. And this is currently installed at Sneca servers. Next, we have the test environment. This is the environment that we are actually using here today in this workshop. It has the latest stable version, so it's a working. It's in a working phase. It's accessible to all the SDC partners. It doesn't host the production data, only a subset. And currently, it's installed at the CSE data center. Lastly, we have the production environment. There is the production infrastructure, and it hosts only the stable versions of the software. It's fully working, it has the production data, and it is also installed at the CSE data center. Okay, here is how CSE has deployed all the services. So they are hosting the test and the production infrastructure. They share a few core services, and we see that the data is actually divided in test and a production partition. So here again are the five EUDAT partners. As we said, CSE is the hosting member of the production service. And then Sineka is the hosting member of the development service. So the data is actually coming through the CSC HTTP APIs. So all the data is coming through CSC. If CSC server fails, there is implemented a backup service through Sineka. So if CSC URLs are not accessible, we can ingest the data through Sineka servers. Then when the data has been is incoming, then it's replicated to every other partner. So the data then is replicated to Sineka, DKRG, GRNet and STFC. And it's also registered, so each replicated data we can confirm that is the original one. So in order to download, to get back the uploaded data, you can use either one of the provided proxies. So this was the EUDAT CDI deployment and how it is managed in a technical way. Also, GRNet and EUDAT is providing a monitoring service to in order to ensure that everything is up and running smoothly. So monitoring for SDC, users need to have access to the SDC services. The most common thing is that most of the services and the servers look seems to be okay, so they are on the power, they are working, but until the users is actually has a problem and they start complaining. So maybe they cannot log in, they cannot actually download the data, or they just see the web page with an error message. So the problem is that we don't want to have long downtimes or long periods the service not to be accessible. The solution is to monitor, analyze, report and alert the site admins for any kind of problem. The service and the software that is used to monitor all this is called Argo. And Argo is trying to emulate what a user would actually do when using the service. So, for example, if a user would hit the login button, Argo is actually trying to imitate this behavior. So, it provides us a real-time status report, an availability and reliability report, and also it provides alerts for the site admins so they can take action and solve any problem that occurs. So also a web interface is provided for the status report. Here in the green timeline, we can see that a service is up and running for a long time, and with the red dots, we see if we have a critical error or a warning. Then the responsible site admin must be contacted in order to take action. And also we have a log for It's with a timestamp when the check was made and if the service was available or not. Last, here is a message when something is failing. We have this alert that is coming through the email to the responsible person, and after that you need to take action. So that was it. It was a bit technical, so I tried to keep it small. Don't know if any questions are needed or just leave the floor. How? Okay, so the question is how we are managing the backup. So yes, actually, all the EUDAT members are used as a backup, as a replicated server. So everything that is ingested through a single proxy through CSC. Then with a B2Safe replication, it's automatically replicated to the rest data centers. So yes, this is done automatically. When you upload, you register your data, and then it's automatically replicated to all the data centers. Okay, thank you.